Let's take a look at some of the analytics that we have access to using AF. The first is the expression. The expression analysis is a type of equation. You can craft out your own analysis using different functions in order to calculate whatever you're looking for. To craft the expression analysis, let's look at some guidelines. First, attributes, tag names, and timestamps are written using single quotes. Next, strings are written in double quotes. Numbers, operators, and functions require no special syntax. And if you'd like to add a comment, use the forward-facing double slash. Let's take a look at building one of the expression analyses ourselves using Pi System Explorer. First, I'll open up Pi System Explorer. And I've created a very simple database in order to show you just how the basics of expressions are created. I can see I have a plant, a production line, and my asset. On my asset, if I go over to the Attributes tab, I see that the only thing that I have is a flow rate. What I would like to see is see the total amount of flow that has gone out of my asset in the last hour. To begin configuring our analytics, we'll go over to the Analyses tab. We'll click on Create a New Analysis. And we can give it a name. Over on the right, I can see that the analysis type is expression, and this is what I would like to use. In order to calculate the total amount of flow over the last hour, I'm going to use the tag tote function. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see all the functions that we have available. To learn more about these different functions, I recommend going to the help in PSE. Let's take a look at that now. In the Help page, I'll go to Pi System Explorer 2017, Asset Analytics, and then Expression Functions Reference. Below Expression Functions Reference, I have all the different functions with some examples and how to use them. In my case, I'm already familiar with the functions reference, and I know that I'll be using tag tote. So I can see here, using the reference, that tag tote will give me the totalized value of a time integral of an attribute's values over a specified time range. I can also convert the totalized value from the current unit of measure to a specified unit of measure in the same class. For the syntax, I'll use tag tote, then the attribute name, then the start time, and then the end time for the interval that I'm interested in. For me, it'll be over the last hour. I also have the optional parameter to change the units of measure, and I also have the option to add in percent good. What this means is that if there are not enough good values, then I will not calculate this expression. Let's start building this function. There's also autocomplete that helps me craft my analyses. As soon as I start typing, there's a completion. It allows me to choose from a drop-down menu. Pressing the down arrow, I can scroll through, select tag tote, and hit enter. It helps me build out what I need next. I can see that I need the attribute name. For attribute names, I'll need to use single quotes. As soon as I use a single quote, it pulls my list of attributes. I can hit enter here, or I can continue typing out flow rate, or I can click on flow rate itself. After double clicking, it inserts flow rate in single quotes and marks it as green, just like we intended. I use a comma, and then I need to specify my start and end times. I would like to do this total as a rolling total over the last hour. To do so, I will use from 1 hour ago until now as my times. Timestamps are going to be passed using single quotes. That's my start time, and I'll put in my end time. I could include a unit of measure to convert to, but in this case, I would like to leave it. I could also add in a percent good, but I do not need to do that in this case either. At this point, I can click evaluate and see if it comes out to a regular value, and I could see if that makes sense to me.
This answer does not seem right to me as the total amount of flow that went through this device in the last hour. The tagtote function by default assumes that the units are on a per day basis. Because our flow rate is on a per minute basis, I'll need to multiply by 1,440, which are the amount of minutes in a day. Once I do this and test the evaluate button again, I can see a more expected result.
Now, what might make this easier to read? This is a pretty simple calculation. Let's say I'm making something a bit more difficult, and I want to make sure that I annotate my work. I can add in a comment at the top. To have this comment stay at the top, I'll hold Shift and hit Enter. You'll notice that the entire top line is commented out, then it goes into my typical function to create the tag tote. Let's say I'd like to make this a little bit more sophisticated. One thing that I can do is save the first piece as a variable, then later use that variable later on in the same analysis. Let's see how to do that. I'm going to name, instead of variable 1, I'm going to give this a variable name of total flow, and I'll make sure not to include any spaces. If I include spaces, I can't use it as a variable name. And click Add a New Variable. And I'm going to use the total flow in some kind of logic. I'll say if the total flow is greater than 50, I want this flag to be set to 1. Otherwise, I want it set to 0. The autocomplete will also pick up all the variables in the expression. And I can click on Evaluate to see. In the next video, we're going to explore some of the other functions, and we'll talk about different use cases for when you might use them.